Biopiracy is the illegal act in the appropriation of life and traditional knowledge without recognizing, respecting, or adequately compensating rightful owners of the life forms appropriated or the traditional knowledge related to their propagation, use, and commercial benefits. In a famous example, the Eli Lilly Company used rosy periwinkle extracts to make cancer-fighting drugs. The plant is native to the island of Madagascar.
The rosy periwinkle, known by the botanical name Catranthus roseus, is a hero native to the island of Madagascar. It is a branch perennial shrub that can reach 2.5 feet in height when it's fully mature. It has a oval-shaped leaves with white or pinkish flowers, each featuring 5 lobe petals.
In 1954, the American firm Eli Lilly, a pharmaceutical company, extracted tau alkaloids called vinblastine and vincristine from the rosy periwinkle, which are used to treat childhood leukemia and cases of Hodgkin disease, respectively.
If you're looking for a plant that can really take a hot Texas summer, Madagascar periwinkle is an excellent choice. This flowering plant also goes by the name of vinca. Back years ago, it was a very popular plant, in fact, a staple in our landscapes, and then due to a disease called Phytophthora aerial blight that tends to splash up on the plant and cause areas to die out, it kind of fell from favor. Now it's back again. There are some varieties that are resistant, but we've learned a lot how to avoid that disease. The primary way is to wait until it warms up. Don't even think about planting these until about May or June. They'll hit the ground running. The hot weather doesn't bother them as long as you provide a moderate amount of moisture for them to get started.
Traditionally, the periwinkle is used to cure diabetes. But when its cancer-fighting abilities were discovered, Eli Lilly, who had isolated the cancer-fighting abilities of the herb, took credit for it and patented drugs made from this. Eli Lilly went on to make millions of dollars with the drugs, but the people of Madagascar never received any compensation for their knowledge of the herb's healing abilities. When countries establish bioprospecting agreements with corporations, the payments and benefits are very low, even if the drugs discovered are widely successful.